Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about Pyroxicam. What is this drug Pyroxicam? The suffix oxicam indicates this drug belongs to the category of NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents. Being a oxicam derivative, this drug is useful as analgesic, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory agent. But from the name of this drug, we can draw few of the structural information. Here the infix oxy indicates this drug is having 1,2-benzothiazine-11-dioxide ring system. So this is a 6+6 member ring system with one sulfur and nitrogen at first and second positions. Similarly, the suffix cam indicates this drug is having the carboxamide moiety. And the prefix pyr indicates it is having the pyridine ring system. So pyroxicam is a pyridine substituted 1,2-benzothiazine-11-dioxide derivative with carboxamide functional group. So today in this video we are going to discuss about this pyroxicam, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses and clinical use of this drug we will discuss in this video. So what is the clinical use of this pyroxicam? All we have seen, this is a NSAID, so it is acting like analgesic, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory agent. So this drug is particularly used in two types of arthritis. One is the rheumatoid arthritis and second is the osteoarthritis. Even both are going to affect the bones and joints. A small difference is there between the rheumatoid arthritis and osteoarthritis. In the rheumatoid arthritis, we can observe symmetrical joint disorder, whereas in the osteoarthritis, it initially starts as asymmetrical, so we can observe joint disorders only on one side of the body. And finally, so many joints are going to be affected in the osteoarthritis. Similarly, another difference is that in the rheumatoid arthritis, joints of fingers and toes are mainly affected. But in the osteoarthritis, we can observe the joint disorders which are associated with bearing the weight of the body. So joints such as knees and hip are mainly affected in the osteoarthritis. Third point of difference between these two clinical disorders is that rheumatoid arthritis is one of the autoimmune disorder where the immunity is improperly stimulated, resulting in the release of autoantibodies which attack the joints, leading to inflammation. But the osteoarthritis is a degenerative disorder. So here we can observe a slow erosion of cartilage which results in the joint pain and stiffness in the patients. Even these two clinical disorders are different. Few of the symptoms are somewhat similar. We can observe joint pain, stiffness of the joints and muscle weakness. But the onset of symptoms is again different in these two conditions. In the rheumatoid arthritis, we can observe the symptoms more pronounced during the morning. Whereas in the osteoarthritis, the symptoms are mild in the morning and they are more observed at the end of the day. Now, even these two clinical disorders are somewhat different. They are affecting the joints, resulting in the joint pain and stiffness. So pyroxicam can be used to control the pain as well as joint stiffness in both rheumatoid arthritis as well as osteoarthritis. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug pyroxicam. So this is the structure of pyroxicam and here we can observe it is having the benzothiazine ring system. Let us give the numbering. We can start the numbering from the sulfur. So this is 1, then 2, 3, 4 and so on. Now this ring is nothing but 1,2-benzothiazine, but it is having a amide moiety at the third position. So we can write this as 1,2-benzothiazine-3-carboxamide. Then we can easily identify further chains attached at the different positions. Fourth position hydroxy group is present and first position dioxo group is present, so 11-dioxo. And on the nitrogen of the amide, pyridine ring is attached by second position, so N-pyridine-2-aryl. So that is the complete name of pyroxicam. Now let us see how this drug acts. Phospholipid membrane acts as a source of prostaglandins and thromboxanes. So when there is a stress or inflammatory stimuli, it can stimulate one of the enzyme phospholipase A2. This phospholipase A2 is a cleavage enzyme which can cleave the phospholipids in the membrane, such that from the phospholipids, one of the mediator is going to be released, which is nothing but arachidonic acid. This arachidonic acid is a C20 fatty acid, which is having the four double bonds. So it's also called as icosatetraenoic acid. Now this arachidonic acid can be converted into different types of mediators by different pathways. One of the important pathways is the COX pathway, cyclooxygenase pathway. Here two types of enzymes are present, COX1 as well as COX2. COX1 is constitutive in nature, which is always present, but COX3 is inducible. During the inflammation, COX3 is going to be induced, which can act on this arachidonic acid and cleave this arachidonic acid into two important mediators, PGG2 and PGH2. These are the cyclic endoperoxides. Now again, they are going to be further converted into prostanoids and thromboxanes by the same enzyme COX with peroxidase activity. Now this PGG2 and PGH2 are going to be converted into different types of prostanoids such as PGE2, PGI2 as well as thromboxane A2. The prostaglandins such as PGE2 and PGI2 are responsible for vasodilatation, resulting in the increased inflammatory response, whereas thromboxane A2 can activate the platelets, resulting in the platelet aggregation and thrombotic events. Now here PIROXICAM can control this inflammatory response. Now PIROXICAM can bind to this COX enzyme. It can block both COX1 as well as COX2 enzyme. Thereby, it inhibits the synthesis of prostaglandins as well as thromboxane A2. So when these are not synthesized, inflammation can be controlled, resulting in the decreased pain, swelling, and stiffness of the joints. Apart from this mechanism, PIROXICAM can also scavenge the free radicals, and it can also inhibit the lymphocyte activity. By all of these, it can reduce the inflammation, thereby can reduce the pain and stiffness in the joints. Now let us see the precautions of PIROXICAM. So we have seen that arachidonic acid is a C20 fatty acid, which is going to be converted into prostaglandins such as PGI2, which is also called as prostacycline, and this conversion is mediated by COX pathway. Now this PGI2 can act on the blood vessels and acts as vasodilator. So these blood vessels are expressed with IP receptors, which are the receptors for prostacycline. Now this PGI2 can act on these IP receptors, which produce vasodilatation. This vasodilatation may lead to the inflammation. That's why PIROXICAM is one of the NSAID, which is going to inhibit this COX pathway, thereby inhibits the synthesis of prostacycline. And when this prostacycline is not synthesized, it results in the decreased vasodilatation, resulting in the vasoconstriction of the blood vessels. Now, because of this vasoconstriction, platelets come nearer and they can be activated and aggregated, which results in few of the thrombotic events. So PIROXICAM can increase the platelet activation and aggregation, resulting in the increased risk of myocardial infarction, increased risk of stroke in the patients. So care should be taken when this drug is prescribed in the patients with cardiovascular disorders, and any previous history of myocardial infarction or stroke, in such patients this drug is contraindicated. Similarly, PIROXICAM can increase the hepatotoxicity. So liver enzymes such as ALT, alanine transaminase, AST, aspartate transaminase, these liver enzymes can be increased with chronic use of PIROXICAM. So suppose ALT and AST levels are hanging the normal upper limits like this. After administration of PIROXICAM, they may be increased 3 times to the upper limit. In such case, we can observe few of the symptoms in the patient, such as lethargy, weakness in the patient, diarrhea, jaundice, pruritus. All these can be observed, which indicate there is a hepatotoxicity in the patients. So in such situation, the liver functionality test should be done. And in case of elevation of liver enzymes up to 3 times of upper normal limit, then this drug should be stopped and replaced with another suitable agent. Similarly, arachidonic acid can be converted into other prostaglandins such as PGI2 as well as PGE2. Again, both of these are protective prostaglandins at the stomach, and these prostaglandins are again synthesized by COX pathway. But here COX1, which is the constitutive enzyme present at the GI epithelium, is mainly responsible for synthesis of these prostaglandins. Now, once these prostaglandins are synthesized, they can act on the prostaglandin receptors. Now, normally, gastric parietal cells can release the gastric acid, but this release of gastric acid is controlled by these prostaglandins. So, prostanoid receptors are present at the GI epithelium. When these prostaglandins bind to these prostaglandin receptors, they can inhibit the release of gastric acid. In this way, prostaglandins can control the gastric acid secretion. Now, when this PIROXICAM is used, it can inhibit this COX pathway. Thereby, it can inhibit the synthesis of these protective prostaglandins. When these are not synthesized, the gastric acid secretion is not controlled. So, gastric acid is excessively secreted, which results in the increased GI bleeding and ulceration. So, PIROXICAM can increase the inflammation, ulceration, perforation of the stomach and esophagus, and gastrointestinal bleeding. All this can be increased by PIROXICAM. So, care should be taken in the patients having any history of gastric ulceration or perforation. Again, we can observe another effect with synthesis of PGE2 and PGI2. These prostaglandins synthesized by COX pathway again play an important role at renal system. At the efferent arterioles, these prostaglandins can produce vasodilatation, which results in the increased rate of filtration. Again, at the efferent arterioles, these prostaglandin receptors are present. Now, when these prostaglandins bind to these prostaglandin receptors, they can increase the efferent arteriole vasodilatation, resulting in the increased rate of perfusion and increased rate of glomerular filtration. In this way, prostaglandins can increase the renal functionality, where this PIROXICAM acts in opposite direction. PIROXICAM inhibits this COX pathway, thereby it inhibits the action of these prostaglandins, leading to decreased glomerular filtration rate. Because of reduced renal perfusion, the potassium levels within the serum can be elevated, resulting in the hyperkalemia, which is fatal, leading to some cardiac arrhythmias. And because of reduced perfusion, this PIROXICAM should be carefully given in the patients who are having the dehydration, hypovolemia, or congestive heart failure, where edema can be further increased by this PIROXICAM. And in the patients with any liver dysfunction, in all these patients, this PIROXICAM should be carefully given, because it further increases these symptoms by reducing the renal perfusion. Similarly, PIROXICAM can increase the blood pressure, resulting in the hypertension. So, the patients who are taking the antihypertensive agents such as AC inhibitors, angiotensin receptor blockers, the dose may be adjusted, otherwise they are somewhat inactive because of raising the blood pressure. Similarly, this drug can produce some hypersensitive reactions like Stevens-Johnson syndrome. Otherwise, it can produce serious hypersensitive reactions such as toxic epidermal necrolysis. Now, let us see the side effects of PIROXICAM. The important side effects are mainly related with gastrointestinal system. So, this drug can produce some dyspepsia, headache, flatulence, abdominal pain, and because of decreased renal perfusion pressure, it can produce edema, which results in the increased heart failure and palpitations, awareness of heartbeat, some tinnitus, buzzing noise in the middle ear, vertigo, reeling sensation. Similarly, other side effects like constipation, pruritus, blurred vision, and drowsiness can be observed with this PIROXICAM. How it is given? This drug is available as capsules at a strength of 10 mg as well as 20 mg. It is also available as suppository for rectal as well as gel for topical purpose. The dose of the drug is initiated at 20 mg given once daily. It can be given as a single dose or it can be divided into two doses in order to manage joint pain and stiffness in the patients. But again, care should be taken in view of hepatotoxicity and gastric bleeding and ulceration. So, any of these symptoms are observed, immediately the dose should be reduced and even it should be stopped based on the clinical condition. So, that's about this drug PIROXICAM. PIROXICAM is an oxycam derivative with 1,2-benzothiazine 1,1 dioxide ring along with carboxamide moiety at the third position. In addition to the inhibition of COX pathway, this drug also acts as free radical scavenger and also inhibits the inflammatory response. By all of these actions, this drug acts as analgesic, antipyretic, and anti-inflammatory agent. That's why this drug is indicated in the treatment of both rheumatoid arthritis as well as osteoarthritis. So that's about this drug Pyroxicam. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.